Now we have two rules again, or two rules in our languages. I don't know why I use these funny symbols that I can't pronounce, but whatever. Alright, so we gotta figure out what's going on here. And the best piece of advice I can ever give you is look for easy stuff. What's easy to do? What can you do that's easy? So first, what do we start with? So let's do some comparison and subtraction so that we can do easy stuff. So what might we compare? Look, the first four forms all start with what?
The V,
and they all have a shared meaning, which is what?
With.
Yeah. So maybe,
you know, V prefix, brackets, means with, right?
Actually, I say with. You say with or with?
With.
Voiced or voiceless?
Voiceless.
Yeah, you all say with. Yeah, I say with. Okay. And then, so it looks like, look, you figured something out already, right? V means with, or with. And what else? And okay, before we subtract, let's do another comparison. We got a bunch of things. I mean, 4, 4, 4, 4, 4, and they all start with sis, 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 sis. So maybe S means 4. Of course, already I'm cheating because maybe it's sad, or maybe it's more. But since we're running out of time, I'm going to lead you on the right path. And because there's something funny going on with the vowels up here, so I don't want to get distracted by that. Okay, so let's say we figure that out, because I'm trying to rush it a bit. Okay? Once you get that, what do? You go to
singular
or plural. Okay, so what's singular? So if we compare all the singulars, right, they're not next to each other. 1, 2, 3, 4. They all have an a. Okay, so maybe singular is an a suffix. Again, this is not necessarily obvious and apparent, but it's one possibility, and we're going to go with it now. And what's the plural?
On.
On, right? On. On is for plural. Right. Okay, so once we have that, let's do easy stuff. So now we got two roots. One means sheep and one means ox. Which is the easy one?
Sheep.
Sheep, sheep, sheep. Sheep is what? So where's the sheep forms? Here, 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 here. Yeah. Sheep has one form only. Sheep. It's always F, right? Am I right?
Yeah.
And so we know that this is going to be F, unless if all goes well, right? NAA seems to work. Okay. So now what do we have? For ox, what are the surface forms for ox? Okay, so let's look at the choice. Here's this, 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 and this. How many are there?
Four.
Okay, so what are they? I, H.
Yeah.
What else?
I,
th. E,
H.
E, H.
E,
H. Yeah. Okay. So this kind of helps us see why we don't want to do what Sarah kind of did informally, where she had, you know, like, or is this something that somebody did, you know, pock going to this or that. But we want to do this in terms of segments, because we can, even though we have four forms, how many rules do we need? Well, how many, let me put it a different way. How many segment alternations are there? Yeah. There's an EA alternation, and there's a the H alternation, and if we just do the combinatorics of this, we get 4. Okay, but we don't need 4 rules, we just need 2 rules. Okay? So this is much harder than real problems because it's hard to tell what's going on because there's so few forms and it's minimal. But let's see if we can so what do we have? We have okay, so think about this. What do you think is a better choice to guess? What do you think is going to be right for the whether ox has an A or an E in it? Think
might be best, because this, why?
She has.
Yeah, sheep is different. Okay, there's complications here because there's other differences between them. But let's try it with, let's just try it with this and see if we can get something to work. We won't go through all the reasoning, or will we? Let's see. Make it work by assuming that it's this and that the consonant is different as well, that it's this. Okay? This is another one of those cases where there's multiple solutions. I just want to get you to see one way to make this work. Okay, so if we assume that ox is this, what rules do we need? How can we get things to work out right?
I comes E in front of S.
Don't say in front of, because
after.
Some people call that after.
After.
So before or after use. So what? I becomes E. So which one do we take care of? This one? I'm losing track.
Yes.
So we need I to E here and here?
Yeah.
In those two. Okay. Yeah, so is it? Yeah, that will work. Okay, so we need to roll I becomes E after S. That's easy. Okay. And why don't we get any I's in sheep? Why don't the sheep forms ever have an I?
Right,
we either get I's that are underlying or they get changed into E's. But these words don't have any I's, so there's no reason for them to have any I's. And what's the other form? What's the other rule we need? We need to deal with this. So this is an underlying I. This is an underlying I. We need these guys to change. And yeah, I think that works, right? So here, we got to raise the forms. It's just here and here. Right, this is a th because it's an underlying th. This is an underlying th. This is an underlying th. This is an underlying th. So it's just this form and this form. Yeah, so it's hard to see, but it's what is it?
H becomes
the. H becomes the before R. Okay? We can look at derivations. Okay, so that's H. I changed it because I didn't feel like writing it. That becomes the before O, and I becomes E after S. And you can see, so I think of that as an H, it turns into a the before O, and that's the only rule that's relevant. Why doesn't the I turn into an E? Because it's not after S, right? So that's the only rule that's relevant to those forms. And then we go to the next set of forms, and we have these forms where H doesn't become still before O, it's not before an O, and I becomes E before after S, that happens here. And then remember, every form goes through the same phonology, right? So this form happens to be, it happens to have it's subject to the. Is that a mistake? No, it's not a mistake here. H to the before O, and I to E after S. So this form happens to be affected by both rules. Okay? So this example has four oxen ends up homophonous with four sheep. Okay? And in this case, it's because this form in the ox word got affected by two different rules. And so you get homophony because one paradigm, this word wasn't affected at all, and this one got affected by two rules. This is why it's important to put your glosses in, so we know which you're doing the right derivation. Right? But every time we have ox, we got IH, 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 whatever. But in this case, this form got affected by two rules and we have homophony here.